This is the story of Miss Chill and Mr. Haughty. Yeah, I know that Mr. Haughty was the hottest person who has ever been to Earth. But what is the point if he destroys everything? Whatever he held, melted. Whatever he touched, got burned to ashes. Nobody could touch him. Whoever went close to him got drenched in sweat. And that's why nobody wanted to be with him. He had no friends and was lonely. Oh wait! Run! He's coming! Hey, let's meet Miss Chill now. She is the coolest person I have ever met. Whatever comes her way, she chills that. She is always relaxed, calm, and spread coolness. Now you must be thinking, what will happen when Mr. Haughty and Miss Chill meet? Will Miss Chill cool Mr. Haughty? And how? Or would Miss Chill also lose her cool? Watch this video till the end to know their mind-blowing story. Everybody loves Miss Chill, but someone has said it right. Nothing comes for free. It costs a lot to be Miss Chill because she is hungry. Too much power hungry. And it is not good for our pockets. But why Miss Chill consumes a lot of energy? Let's find out. For Miss Chill to perform effortlessly and chill everything, she needs to work a lot and she has several body parts to take care of. Majorly, there is one outdoor and an indoor unit. The outdoor unit includes compressor, expansion valve and condenser coil. And the indoor unit has the evaporator coil, along with an electric circuit, thermostat, etc. She also has two fans, one at the evaporator and one at the condenser coil. There are also a few connecting pipes, which connect all these parts together. Thus, the flow loop is formed. You know that Miss Chill chills everything by removing the heat from one place, filling it with cold air and expelling the hot air outside where no one cares. For that exchange of heat, Miss Chill also requires a special fluid, which is called refrigerant or coolant. In general, we call it the gas. It works as a messenger and flows through pipes and parts of Miss Chill. It changes its state from liquid to gas and gas to liquid continuously. Why? We will talk about it later. Now, everything starts here at the compressor. You can think of it as the heart of Miss Chill. It compresses the refrigerant when it is in the gaseous form. It squeezes it very tightly. This raises the pressure in the gas and causes it to heat up. Since heat naturally flows from higher to lower temperatures, we want the temperature of the refrigerant to be higher than the outer temperature. That is why we need a compressor to compress the refrigerant. This high pressure and high temperature refrigerant will go to the condenser coil through connecting pipes. Here, the gas will turn into a liquid without changing its temperature. Now, this heat energy is absorbed from the refrigerant. With the use of a condenser fan, it is dissipated outside. As the heat leaves, the refrigerant turns back into liquid. The liquid refrigerant then leaves the condenser coil and reaches the expansion valve. The liquid refrigerant has given away its heat, but it is still too hot. The expansion valve expands the refrigerant liquid and cools it down. The expansion is opposite to compression. As the compressor squeezed the gas and raised its temperature, the expansion valve decompresses the liquid and reduces its temperature. Now this cold liquid refrigerant enters the evaporator coils. The evaporator coils are in the indoor unit of the air conditioner. Now the fan blows the room heat on the cold evaporator coil and the cold liquid refrigerant flowing inside absorbs that heat. As the room's heat is absorbed by the cold refrigerant, the room starts to get chilled and the liquid refrigerant changes its state to gas. Now the hot gaseous refrigerant reaches the compressor and the process is repeated continuously in a closed loop and Miss Chill keeps cooling the room. All of this is dependent upon a very interesting phenomenon. That is, if a liquid evaporates into a gas, it absorbs heat. That's because the molecules in a liquid are held together by a weak intermolecular interaction When they absorb heat, they start to move fast. And if the heat is strong enough, the molecules overcome the intermolecular interaction and escape into a gaseous form. That's the reason why we feel cool when we sweat. The water has to absorb heat to evaporate. And this is what is happening in the air conditioners. The refrigerator in our homes also works similarly. And that's how Miss Chill is able to extinguish the fire of Mr. Hot Tea. And yes, all of this requires a lot of electrical energy. So, use your air conditioners wisely. That's all in this episode of Explained. And don't forget to watch our other videos.